Kill the worshipers! Where's all of my praises? I want everybody around the world to put your hands together because all the praise belongs to God. Here we go.
Looking at him a little different. I was like, that's a nice little guy there. So then I started talking to the Lord about him. I was like, I wonder if he's married, Lord.
Come on, say every praise. Say every praise. It's to our God. Y'all know how we do it. Take it up. Every praise. It's to our God. Every word of worship. With one accord. Come on, say every praise.
Every praise
is to our God. I want everybody all over the world to sing hallelujah, to our God. Glory,
hallelujah
is to our God.
Every praise
is to our God. Let's take it up one more time.
Every praise.
Come on, everybody.
Every word of worship
with one accord. Every praise
is
to our God. I don't care how you're feeling right now. Sing hallelujah,
sing hallelujah
to our God.
Standing there long, he said, no, I just came over. I was over in the Walmart, and they gave me a receipt. And on the back, it's a coupon, and it says that I can get my hair cut in this salon for $9.99. Is that true? And I said, yes, it's true. And he said, well, would you be the one to cut it? And I said, sure, I can cut it. And then I looked at his head, and I said, you don't have any hair.
Yeah.
no, I don't need a haircut. I just wanted to come over and talk to you. He said, something told me to come over and talk to you today. And he said, no, I'm not going to say something. He said, God sent me over here. He said, I've been looking at you for a while, but God told me that today was the day.
The Bible says he's supposed to abide fast with her and to catch her by pursuit. This word has revolutionized our relationship together because I began to pursue my wife, and I've come to understand that every woman wants to be pursued by her husband. Woo!
We would like to say falling in love with Jesus was the best thing we ever done. And we would encourage you guys to put Jesus first in your life. Put the Lord first, and all other things will come to you.
William, practice this with me now. I'm sorry. Will you forgive me? And I'll try not to do it again. And if that doesn't work, jewelry, jewelry, jewelry.
Hello, the word that we have for you tonight is, or this afternoon, is listen. And there's a lot of ways you can listen, and the one main purpose and person or place to go with your listening is to God. I take an example from Joshua. Joshua got to a point in his life like you are, William. He's made a change in a direction that he was going in. He was a follower, or he was just a man going about doing what he did, but God moved him to take on the lead.
So as you listen to the Holy Spirit and you follow the guidance of the Holy Spirit, he's going to make you a dynamic wife. And we're excited to partnership with you guys.
We would just like to say congratulations. Beautiful wedding. Really enjoyed ourselves. Thank you for the invite. And may God just bless your union.
Today has been a wonderful, wonderful day in the life of my family, especially my youngest daughter, who was married, and she and her husband now are ready to experience a wonderful, wonderful life together. I want to thank you all for helping us to enjoy today's events. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Come on, you ought to lift your hands and praise him now. He's worthy of the praise. I don't care what you've been through.
William, I'm telling you what, ever since you brought Sharonda over to our house that first night, I always knew, in fact, my wife and I coming after y'all left, I said, boy, she will make a wonderful wife for William. I see you brought all the past today, so congratulations, cuz you made the right decision. Keep up with it, okay? God bless.
Hey, William and Sharonda. It's hard not to call you chick. But anyway, congratulations. This was a beautiful ceremony, a beautiful reception. I'm wishing God's peace and blessings on you. May you all enjoy your honeymoon. And I'm looking forward to nieces and nephews. See ya.
And in praise.